Hey guys, Hafadet here with a short video. Here to show you how to reduce the input lag of the DualShock 4 controller for free by overclocking the polling rate. If you haven't watched my previous input lag test videos, then you may not know a fact that sounds quite surprising at first. The DS4 has a higher average input lag when using a wired connection than it does when using Bluetooth. If you want the full results and discussion of that, then watch the video in the top right. In that video, I also mentioned a test from WID-D which overclocked the polling rate of the DS4 to 1000 Hz over wired, which reduced the input lag to roughly the same as Bluetooth. A wired connection is more consistent and therefore such an overclock is superior to just using it wirelessly. The issue was that I didn't know how to replicate such an overclock on Windows, but thanks to Valti on Discord, I do now. But first, I want to discuss the differences. Of course, I wanted to do my own test to see whether the input lag actually goes down exactly like it did in WID-D's test. The answer is yes. What you can gain from doing this is a 7 millisecond reduction in average input lag compared to wired. And the standard deviation ends up as low as the best devices out there. So, is there anything you have to be scared of? I'm not aware of any device being damaged by such an overclock. The software is used by many to overclock their mice and seems to be safe to use. However, you still have to do this at your own risk. I'm not responsible for any issues that could be caused by the software. Now for the how-to. First, you need to open the link in the video description and download the hidusbf.zip file. Extract everything in the zip file, go into the driver folder and open setup.exe. At the top left, there will be a drop-down menu which has mice selected by default. Change that to all so you can find the DS4 controller. Unfortunately, the controller isn't clearly labeled. But the easiest way to figure out which one it is by the B interval column in the table. The DS4 by default has a B interval of 5. If you happen to have multiple devices with a B interval of 5 connected, then you will find the DS4 by looking at the child names column. It should list audio endpoints with the name wireless controller and HID compliant game controller. If you can't find it, make sure it's actually connected by wire and working normally. Try disabling any controller configuration like DS4 Windows or X360 CE. When you've found it, click on it once so it's highlighted. Then press the button Install Service, put the check mark in Filter on Device, and select a rate of 1000. It's all set up now, and all you need to do is unplug your controller and replug it. If the DS4 then shows a B interval of 1, it was successful. Note that this is a system and controller based change. This means it's only active for this specific controller on your specific PC. The software does not need to be open, but it could set itself back on a Windows update. So you might want to open it in the future to check the B interval. If it is back to 5, then you will likely need a new version of the software. If you want to reverse the overclock for some reason, untick Filter on Device, set the rate to default and replug the device. This probably leaves you all with one question. Does this work on other controllers? The overclocking part should work with any controller. However, the benefit won't necessarily be the same. In both WID-D's testing as well as the study from the University of Regensburg, the DS4 was the controller that benefited the most. The Xbox 360 controller and the DS3 didn't change at all, for example. At some point, I'm going to revisit all the controllers I have and retest them with an overclocked polling rate. But for now, I wanted to get this video out so you can use it to your advantage already. Shout out to my patrons for supporting me financially. To stay up to date, follow me on Twitter or join my Discord, and I'll see you soon for the next video.